हाय, वेलकम बैक चैनल पर। आज बात करते हैं Amazon Prime Video की सीरीज मॉडर्न लव सीजन 2 की। इफ यू हैवंट वॉच सीजन 1, डोंट वरी अबाउट इट, बिकॉज हर एपिसोड इज लाइक अ शॉर्ट फिल्म अनटू इटसेल्फ, एक्सप्लोरिंग वन थीम अबाउट मॉडर्न लव। आई नो आई एम कमिंग टू दिस लेट, बट द लास्ट फ्यू वीक्स हैव बीन mentally exhausting for various reasons, so I've been taking things slow. पर क्योंकि ये मेरा चैनल है, मैं यहाँ पे अपनी खुद की डेडलाइंस चलाती हूँ। Amazon Prime Video पर Modern Love का सीजन 2 तकरीबन 2 हफ्ते से स्ट्रीम हो रहा है, and it is just as lovely as you've heard. अच्छा, सीजन 1 को पलट कर अगर अभी देखा जाए तो स्टार कास्ट उसकी comparatively ज्यादा पॉपुलर थी। There was Tina Fey, Dev Patel, Oscar winner Anne Hathaway, Hot Priest, Andrew Scott, काफी mainstream faces. Season 2 में you will recognize Anna Paquin, Kit Harington, Tobias Menzies, who you just saw as Olivia Colman ka Prince Charles, but most of the faces, at least for an Indian audience, are new. क्योंकि the star cast of season 1 did what it was supposed to do, na, pull in an audience unfamiliar with the modern love column in the New York Times, generate our interest and then keep us. Season 2 doesn't need that extra push, I guess, क्योंकि proof of concept तो है. You know, the most amazing thing about this series is its ability to empathize with, represent, and hence validate our bizarre experiences as they occur in the big crazy cities we live in. Knight in shining armor, या Cinderella at the ball, ऐसी stories जिन्होंने बचपन में दिमाग खराब कर दिया था, उन्हीं के भिन्न भिन्न iterations we've seen in mainstream rom-coms for decades on end, creating unrealistic standards around romantic relationships, not taking into account how the evolving world alters love on molecular levels. Modern Love Season 2 opens with the most emotional story of the lot. I loved this one. Uncharacteristically not set in New York or any city. On a serpentine road with a top down is the story of a woman looking to sell her old car. Lekin is having emotional issues with making the actual sale, क्योंकि it was her late husband's and she just has way too many memories associated with it. Mini Driver drives, pun intended, this car and the story towards a wholesome and moving conclusion, which doesn't seem forced, far-fetched or manipulative despite the dead husband angle. Think about it, friends. When someone marries someone and start a family together, the life they create together is full of things. In a loving relationship, every object, every purchase has a story, a reason why it's part of your life. You don't have complete control over which one of you will outlive the other, sadly, but giving up on the things that you owned together, how does one voluntarily get rid of them without feeling the guilt of moving on? It's such a potent emotion. Pehle episode mein maine sabse zyada cry kiya. Next up, Night Girl finds a day boy, takes your regular meet cute at a cafe in a big city and adds a fun little twist to it. The girl has a condition which keeps her awake at night. This short explores what it is to build a relationship with someone with a not so obvious disability within the constraints of our modern lives. It's a unique problem which no film, book, news item, any popular culture has prepared us for. How do you create rules in the absence of a playbook, right? People are just people, na? After all, with varying levels of empathy, limited capability for compassion. Strangers on a Dublin Train stars Kit Harington and Lucy Boynton. And it's the only short which acknowledges the worldwide pandemic we are currently living through. Set right before everything went into lockdown, this funny little story is about two people who try to go old school and choose not to connect via technology. They set a date and a location to meet again instead, not knowing about the impending lockdown. So there's dramatic irony at play here. The funnest bits, they play out in a train where these two meet. There's some over-the-top moments designed to be very adorable. It made me think ki kitne sare magical, wonderful, incredible cheezein hamari life mein hoti hain. And how now for close to 2 years we've been devoid of all of this. Shuru mein sabka tha ki this is good, yaar, I'm telling you we need a break. Par abhi ye break khatam hi nahi ho raha hai. And as the last shot of this film says, ki kab khatam hoga pata nahi. और कितना प्राइस किसको पे करना पड़ेगा ये भी नहीं मालूम। द डायलॉग इन दिस फिल्म इज पर्टिकुलरली फनी स्लैपस्टिक इवन। देयर इज आल्सो गेम ऑफ थ्रोन्स रेफरेंस, हेलो जॉन स्नो। नेक्स्ट, Life Plan for 2, followed by 1, is the weakest of the lot. It's a very regular high school romance story which offers nothing new. Then there is Am I? maybe this quiz will tell me. Now, this is another high school story with the added layer of the protagonist coming to terms with her own sexuality. It's very sweet, it's tender, it involves BuzzFeed quizzes, it's asking how much reliance on social media is too much, how much access to our actual feelings and beings and lives must we give to the algorithms. It's quite nice. In the sixth short, in the waiting room of estranged spouses, this was a really fun exploration of the grey between the black and white of what makes a relationship fall apart. What level of infidelity are you willing to forgive, if any at all? How do kids figure in the situation? When do you begin to see other people? Now, these kind of stories are not never seen before variety. They're not. But very rarely dikhata hai koi itna simply, asani se, relatable, without the melodrama. There's one sequence in the short which stands out where a war veteran is striding along on the sidewalk. He's letting go of his past, he's confronting his PTSD and his broken relationships. It's quite something to watch. How Do You Remember Me? This short takes the Rashomon technique of remembering and recalling the same incident from two different POVs, and then it applies this technique to a very short-lived but overall pleasant relationship between two men. They spot each other on the street and then the flashbacks begin ping-ponging between them both. This short is paced so well, kyunki the duration seemingly is only the time it takes these two men to finish the distance between them on the street, tuk, 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 tuk. But in these roughly 2 minutes, they relive their entire emotional bond, perhaps even wondering where it went wrong. Neither of them is unhappy where they are in life, but they're just thinking if their encounter with each other was in this life or was it a parallel dimension. And lastly, a second embrace with hearts and eyes open. A divorced couple reignites their romance only for a serious illness to come in between. While I liked how wonderfully sappy and sweet this short was, I loved Sophie Okonedo as the lead Elizabeth. Too used to living life as a single mother, a black woman devoted to her work, she has a very fierce defensiveness about her, which most might look at as snobbery, bitchiness even, wondering why she's just so miserable all the time. It makes you stop and check your inherent sexism a little bit as well. Would you say the same if it were a man? Heck, would you feel the same way if it were a white woman protecting herself, making herself her own biggest priority? In cruel irony, none of these defense mechanisms come to her defense when her body begins to fail her. Modern Love Season 2 is a fun, breezy watch you can spread out over weeks. You can come back to an episode whenever you have time and you need a break from life. It excels at simple, non-challenging but satisfying storytelling, a colorful array of acting performances, a lovely title track jo aap kabhi skip nahi karoge. It is all curated to feel like a skit being performed just for you in your living room. It also excels at respectful representation. Cast members are black, Asian, gay, awkward, old, divorced, everything a trope is not. Watch the series on Amazon Prime Video. And zara comments mein batao yahan pe niche which one was your favorite. If I had to pick, I would go for the first episode, the one about the car. You? सब्सक्राइब कर लें चैनल को. बड़े दिनों के बाद थोड़ा दिमागी फंक से बाहर निकली हूँ. अभी हर 2-3 दिन में कुछ नया नया आता रहेगा, देखते रहो. बट सब्सक्राइब प्लीज़.